Hi, welcome. This is Clemens at Elektor. In this video, we will have a look at the Raspberry Pi 400. What exactly is it? Who is it for? And most importantly, what is inside? The Raspberry Pi 400 is a Raspberry Pi 4 built into a keyboard. All that is needed to surf the internet or play games is to connect a mouse and a monitor. The extension connector lets the Raspberry Pi 400 to control things by plugging custom-built interfaces on it. Due to its shape and its extension connector in the rear, the Raspberry Pi 400 reminds of computers from the 80s, like the Commodore 64, the VIC-20 and the ZX Spectrum. Citing a Byte magazine article from that period on the BBC Micro Model B, we can say that the Raspberry Pi 400 is a no-compromise computer that has many uses beyond self-instruction in computer technology. I wonder if they have planned a cassette tape interface for it. Because it is basically a Raspberry Pi 4, the Raspberry Pi 400 has almost the same specifications as an RPi 4 with 4 GB of memory. Besides the shape, there are some differences, however. The Raspberry Pi 400 has a soft power on-off button here, which is good, although I do find its behavior a bit quirky. It powers up or down when you release the button. To power down, sometimes you have to press it for 5 seconds, sometimes only for 1 or 2, and sometimes it even results in a reboot. To fit a Raspberry Pi inside a keyboard while keeping its connectors accessible, the board has been redesigned. Most of the Raspberry Pi 4 connectors, including the 40-pin extension connector, are available on the rear side of the device, but not all. More on that later. Opening the RPi 400 is quite easy, as the keyboard is simply clipped to the bottom shell. There are many clips, about every 4 cm, all around. Once all the clips are undone, you must carefully rotate it topside towards you, because the two parts are held together by the keyboard flexible flat cable, or FFC. Carefully lift the lid on the connector and slide the cable out. You now have 2 separate parts. Put the keyboard aside, it has nothing removable in it. We continue with the bottom part. Most of what's inside is hidden by a metal plate, the heatsink, fixed by 4 tiny screws to the bottom shell. Remove the screws. Now lift the metal plate, but carefully, as it is stuck to the CPU with heat-conducting adhesive tape. The patch of conductive tape on the Ethernet connector comes off easily. Now the circuit board is visible. It is held in place with 2 clips and can be removed easily. Except for its shape, most parts on the board are identical to the ones on a Raspberry Pi 4. The power supply looks a bit different compared to a Raspberry Pi 4, and also the Ethernet connector with its external transformer. The micro SD card connector finally has become a push-push type, which makes replacing the SD card much easier than on other Raspberry Pis, especially when these were mounted inside a case. For cost, size or other reasons, the Ethernet connector does not have any LEDs anymore. The Raspberry Pi 400 did not inherit the camera, display and analog audio video connectors. Dropping the display and AV connectors seems logical, as sound and video are transported perfectly fine over HDMI, of which there are 2. The camera can simply be replaced by a USB webcam. New is, of course, the keyboard connector here. With the IC next to it, a Holtec HD45R0072. This is an 8-bit microcontroller with a USB interface, and its datasheet shows 1 typical application, a USB keyboard, exactly what we have here. Following the traces on the bottom of the PCB, we see that it is connected to the VL805 USB 3.0 host controller. As this is a 4-port device, we now understand why there are only 3 USB connectors left on the Raspberry Pi 400. Next to the USB controller is an unpopulated footprint. On the Raspberry Pi 4, this part is populated. There are even 2 of them, and it appears to be the boot EEPROM. One of its tasks is to replace the file bootcode.bin found in the boot partition on the SD card. A reason not to mount the EEPROM is to save money. Another reason might be to avoid corrupting its contents by clumsy users, limiting stress on the after-sales department. A metal plate almost as large as the keyboard provides the cooling for the CPU. I guess it is also supposed to be connected to ground, as the PCB has a large opening in the solder mask on the ground plane at the position where the heat sink has a tab going down to the PCB. The two should probably touch, but in my RPi 400 they don't. The Raspberry Pi 400 does not have the possibility to replace the memory by a bigger one or to add more. For the moment there is only one model, so unlike the Raspberry Pi 4 or the Compute Module 4, you cannot replace the board by one with more options. Maybe some variants will follow. The Raspberry Pi 400 is a well-designed, easy-to-use and low-cost product for people interested in Python programming on a Linux platform, or just as a cheap computer to surf the internet with. Its friendly looks will definitely attract users who up to now might have been intimidated by the bare Raspberry Pi boards. The flip side is that the Raspberry Pi 400 with its consumer product looks may appeal to an audience not necessarily used to paying attention to technical subtleties. Therefore, some sort of protection of the 40-pin expansion header would have been a welcome addition. Originally, the Raspberry Pi was created with the intention to make computing and programming accessible to people with few resources. However, it quickly found its way into multimedia servers and retro gaming arcades instead. Maybe this time it will end up in the hands of the original target group. Okay, that's it. I hope you found it interesting. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click or tap the bell button. Thank you for watching.